Hey, what's going on team? It's Ricky with TechBuds Garage, and in this video I'm going to be talking about, in my opinion and my experience, the top three cars that I would buy under $10,000. I want you guys to know that this is 100% based off of my opinion, and when it comes down to making the purchase decision of these specific cars, one of the things that I want you guys to know and the reason that I selected these cars is because they're very high demand and high volume cars, very desirable, especially in the areas that I have lived in. These are one of the first cars that I personally purchased that I absolutely fell in love with. And just to put into perspective and just to kind of get the video started, I'm going to be talking about the three cars. I'm not going to be telling you how much you should buy it for. All these cars are different when it comes down to the desired sell price and purchase price, depending on the location that you are within the United States. As we all know, a perfect example can be someone like Weston. Weston is one of the mentors that we have within Flipping Wheels. He's from Arkansas. I'm from California. And you know, a car that might be very desirable in California can be completely different and not as desirable in Arkansas. So the overall price based off of the demand will completely change. And this is something that you can determine as easily as going on your, you know, applications such as Craigslist, OfferUp, Letgo, and Facebook Marketplace to see what these cars are worth within your area. So after you guys watch this video, I want to get your opinion down in the comment section and what you think about the three cars that I chose to put under the best cars or the biggest bang for your buck when it comes down to cars under $10,000. So let's go ahead and get started. This is my all-time favorite, and again, this is going to be my number one pick, 100% based off of preference. And some of you guys might know it as Crowd Killers. Other people might know it as a Ford Mustang, but it's absolutely a car that, you know, I fell in love with. It's one of the first cars that I bought effectively completely by myself. Not one that, you know, the first car that I ever flipped myself, right, to buy to sell for a profit, was something with my brother, and it was a 2012 or 2013 Honda Civic. That was a salvage title we bought through insurance auto auctions. He fully repaired it. He pretty much just taught me the ropes. This car was something that was a complete clean title 2014 murdered black V6 Mustang. It's one that I absolutely fell in love with, but I did it in a very effective way. One of the things that I want to make sure that you guys understand with every car that we purchase within the TechBuds house, TechBuds garage, and just the people that we associate ourselves with, just because you have money doesn't mean that you have to throw it at anything, right? Just because you can. One of the things that I want you guys to understand is how to be an effective buyer. Inform yourself of what that car is worth, what it will be worth after you, you know, put that wear and tear in, after you own it, maybe after 12 months, after 24 months, whatever the case may be, just make sure that you plan ahead. One of the reasons that I want to talk about the 2014 to 2015 Ford Mustang is I've actually seen some 2014 Mustang GTs, which I think are absolute beauties, right, actually selling for less than $10,000. And yes, they might be a little bit more difficult to find. I see a lot of them posted for about $12,000, $12,500, $13,000 in the Arizona area, which is mainly what I look at when it comes down to more millennial-based applications. But I've also seen some posted for about the $10,000 to $9,500 price range. And the reason that this is so important is, no, those are asking prices. A lot of these people are, you know, willing to accept offers. So the more patient that you are, the more selective that you are when it comes down to making the purchase decision on which car is best for you, just know that, you know, you're the final decision maker on what you end up paying for that car. As long as they're willing to negotiate, and depending on, you know, how willing they are to let the car go, you can get an absolute amazing deal, enjoy the car, either break even after a year of ownership, or maybe even actually sell it for a profit. Moving on to the second car, it's going to be anywhere from a 2013, right, to all the way up to a 2015 Camaro. And I have not seen, Camaros are a little bit more expensive based on the area that I live in comparison to Ford Mustangs. I know that a lot of people absolutely love Camaros. I think that they're beautiful cars, but even the SSs. The 2013-2014 SSs, you can actually find them for less than $10,000, and the resale value should be anywhere around $11,500 to $12,000, depending on, you know, the trim and the condition of that specific car. And again, I'm talking about all clean title cars. The V6 Camaro, right, not the SS, 2014-2015, I've been able to see some posts for about $11,000 to $12,000, which means that if you do your part in negotiating, being patient and waiting for that opportunity to present itself, right? If time is not of the essence, right? So you can make the best investment decision to minimize the amount of money that you lose, or at the end of it, either break even or make a profit. Now, one of the last ones that I want to talk about, a lot of you guys can pretty much guess it based off of the previous two that I spoke about, is a Dodge Charger and a Dodge Challenger. I've seen regular V6 2013 up to 2015 Dodge Chargers and Dodge Challengers right around that $10,000 mark. This is a perfect example of how cars depreciate. Those cars, V6s for all of them, Ford Mustang V6, Camaro V6, and the Dodge Charger and Challengers V6 were all selling for over $20,000 as they were brand new from the dealership. But as time goes on and they become a little bit older and the original owner takes that initial depreciating hit, then once you give it time and once you allow the prices to plateau, right, and you do your part as an active kind of like deal hunter to find the best deals in your area, it would not be by any means a surprise if, you know, you could find any of these cars that we just talked about, 2013 body styles or 2015 body styles, for $10,000 or less. I did talk about the Ford Mustang. The Ford Mustangs tend to be a little bit less expensive in comparison to the other two. I don't know why, but I personally, just my preference, and I 100% know I'm super opinionated on this, is I personally love the way that the Ford Mustangs look. 2013, 2014, up to the 2015 body styles. Right before this video, in my area, clean title, there's a 2015 Ford Mustang, which is the newer body style. Not the newest body style, but still the newer body style. And I saw that one posted for about $12,000. So one of the things that I'm gonna do after this video is actually make an offer and try to see if I can get it for less than $10,000. Again, if they don't accept my offer, then I just move on to the next one. I'm in no rush to buy one of those cars. And if I do buy it, it's most likely gonna be for me to be able to buy, enjoy for a little bit, and then be able to sell for a profit, because no question I would be getting one of the best Ford Mustang V6 car deals in Arizona right now. So again, I simply wanted to talk about the three cars that I thought that were the biggest bang for your buck. Not only in experience, because you know they tend to be not much of sports cars, I don't wanna say that, but they're definitely faster than your everyday drivers. On top of that, how beautiful would it be to not only enjoy your car, but either minimize the amount of money that you lose, break even, or actually make a profit while you buy this specific car. A lot of you guys have extra time this summer, so maybe buying one of these cars effectively and efficiently can kind of open your eyes to this new market when it comes down to being able to buy a car, enjoy it, and then later sell it for a profit or break even after you've enjoyed it. So let me know in the comment section what you guys think. So just make sure that you do your part as an active deal hunter to find the best car deals in your area. And if you guys have any questions about any car that you are about to buy, and again, I mean this, if you have any questions about the car deal that you're about to buy, let's make a deal right now. If you are in the market to potentially buy a new car, right, and you want to make sure that you get the best deal possible, I want to offer you this. I would like to jump on a call with you. It's not going to cost you one penny. I'm going to put the first link in the description. Please just make sure that you're actually going to buy a car, right? Either myself, Caleb, or Weston will jump on a call with you, which we're all mentors within the Flipping Wheels group, and we will make sure that we do our part in giving you our 2 cents on what that car is worth in our area and making sure that you get the best deal in your area. And we'll teach you very little simple tips and tricks. And at the end of it, if it's something that you see value and it ends up saving you maybe a couple hundred or a couple thousand dollars, maybe you can give us a little shout out on your Instagram or something like that. Just letting other people know and empowering them to find the best car deals in your area. So really do appreciate you guys' time. I really hope that I earned your thumbs up. It's Sunday. I hope that you guys had an amazing 4th of July weekend. Like always, guys, continue working hard, continue following dreams, let your passion be what drives your success. Hope you guys can subscribe, and like always, let's make sure that we end the year on a green note. Take it easy, team.